Looks like Brendan is just about ready to go. So I'd like to give Brendan a nice introduction here. Brendan O'Neill is here to talk to us today about Sombra. Brendan and Demian Gordon teamed up alongside Brendan's award-winning VFX studio, Bonfire, to form the world's first Web3 VFX studio, which he'll chat with you today about, called Sombra. With a focus on NFTs, digital doubles, real-time cinematics, neural networks, deepfake applications, and Unreal game development, Sombra is designed to bridge the gap between high-level VFX and the Web3 world of wonders. Through their partnership with Xsens and Manus, they have been able to bring their characters to life faster than ever before and have started production on a full-scale cinematic series using Xsens and Unreal 5. Brendan, if you're ready, we'll kick it over to you for your presentation.
Nice to meet you. I appreciate the introduction. Thanks so much. Still setting one quick thing up, but I'll talk through as I kind of, do that. I guess it's, fun to watch that happen, actually. So maybe I'll explain what's happening in this little setup that's going on here. I'm not sure how familiar everybody is thus far, but, obviously we're here, talking about motion capture Xsens, and, obviously we're wearing an Xsens. So this is a Link suit that we're wearing right now, which is one of, the higher end motion capture solutions offered by Xsens. As well as the Xsens Manus gloves, through both our partnerships, like was mentioned. Our project basically, is utilizing characters that really embody these motion capture elements. And you can see some of these on the screen here. And we're gonna get into sort of talking about what our project is, what Sombra as a visual effects studio is with motion capture as a core component, and also sort of what our multiverse ecosystem called Xsens is and how it utilizes motion capture technology to really bring to life multiple characters, as well as sort of in the future, we have hopes, that the community and more will really join into the fun that motion capture can offer when really bringing immersive technology to the metaverse, and also sort of through, a lot of other things that I'm sure are going to develop over time, such as like haptic experiences and more sort of, interactive elemental type kind of, motion capture, events, experiences, in-home sort of use cases. And we also think AI will play a large part in that. But in any event, let's get started and let's talk a little bit about what's going on here. In order to kick this off, we wanted to sort of have one of our characters really embody what we're doing here and sort of walk you through as himself. So we're gonna spin up Alpha 4 here in a moment. Let me just plug in the right IP address for the face. Otherwise you won't be able to see him talk to you. But what we're using here is iClone, which is a familiar software, I think, to many people here. I think there's a few other people in the program today that are actually utilizing a similar workflow. So I think you may have already seen sort of some of these things in the past. But either way, it's really fun to really be able to bring some of these things to life. And we're going to make this full screen now and just do a little mini convo presentation before we start getting into some content and use cases and showing you guys all the fun stuff. Well, we're here. We'll fixate up on top and just make sure everybody can see. Let me check the OBS setting, just make sure. Okay, so this is pretty good. I'll also increase the scale on OBS just so that it can be a little bit better. Cool. So this is Alpha 4. You can sort of see here that we're utilizing, not just the suit, but we're also using the Manus gloves to supplement so we can, do lots of fun hand actions. And we're also using the HMC headgear alongside the, iPhone Live Link app for iClone. And this is just really a pretty simple way to spin up a character. Inside this program, we're able to use Xsens, which is extremely accurate for motion tracking technology, as well as, the Manus gloves and hands, to sort of bring these characters to life. And then we can sort of, not just do what we're doing here, where we vlog, on Twitch or YouTube, but we can also do presentations. We can become these characters in a really unique way. And then we can basically, offer a lot of these types of solutions within our VFX workflow for our cinematic team. So this character is one of our cinematic characters, and he comes to life quite often. Alpha 4 is my name. being able to do this allows us to record this data very quickly. And then through very simple cleanup, you know, mainly with the thumbs, as you can see here, we end up just basically being able to output data extremely fast and then implement that into our workflow within Unreal Engine 5. That offers us solutions that never have existed before in regards to being able to put together storylines extremely quickly, being able to animate characters extremely quickly, and then being able to, you know, refine those characters through Unreal Engine and IK rigs in a way that I think, you know, some recent different short films have shown some of those workflows with that IK rig. You know, Aaron Sims is a good example. Aaron Sims Creative, who did a great presentation with his short film. I don't know how to say it, so I'm not going to butcher the last one. I think it's called I Cathartic or something like that. You can check it out, but that's a great example of using Xsens alongside the Unreal 5 IK rig workflow. But again, that's sort of, you know, the premise of sort of where we're taking our cinematic journey with Xsens and Manus to be able to bring these characters to life. And these characters are, of course, also NFTs. And so we are not just a motion capture VFX shop, but we're also in the world of Web3, NFT technology. You know, we've been offering solutions over the past year to different clients such as NFL, NARS, Ticketmaster, and more to bring to life their sort of creative dreams in the Web3 world, whether it's, you know, custom NFTs for the NFL season and the Super Bowl, or whether it's, you know, a fully animated motion capture film for NARS. We're able to do these things not just with our, you know, motion capture technology, but also through the NFT exploration that we've done. And we find that characters, avatars, things that have movement, interactivity, things that you can see, such as myself here, you know, doing what we're doing now, people really are engaged with that. It's something that really is a beneficial technology to be using within the metaverse, because historically it's been very difficult, I think, to sort of become these characters in such an easy way. And now that we're able to do this, these technologies are being democratized in a way where people at home are suddenly going to be able to do this inside their own living room. And that's going to be really exciting, whether it's through, you know, a window suits that people pick up, or it's through, you know, link suits that they buy, whether it's through, you know, different solutions that they kind of can implement in unison with motion capture technology that Xsens offers. I think that it's going to be a really interesting few years down the pipeline of the metaverse and different content, because, you know, obviously we're using this for cinematic television shows, but also we're using it for animations with our game and a lot of other things that, you know, you can really, I think, see long histories of. And Demian is a good example. You know, if you're not familiar with Demian, my partner here at Sombra, he is a very well-known motion capture technologist and workflow VFX supervisor. He worked at DreamWorks for quite a long time, and, you know, now is in the independent game world. You can definitely look him up, but, you know, him and I have really put a lot of thought, time, and energy into some of these different pipelines that we've created here at Sombra to be able to create content through motion capture technology. Not just cinematic television shows, but also animations for our game that we're developing. And with that, I'm going to showcase a few things here. You know, I want to bring up a couple things that we, you know, will kind of walk you through. Basically, you know, Xsens is the name of the Sombra Network's multiverse. And so I just want to, you know, kind of walk through a little bit about this and show people kind of what we have going on over here. Now, Xsens is, obviously you can see Alpha 4 here is on the front, but what is Xsens? So Xsens is led by Sombra Network, and Sombra Network is, as we've said, a, you know, new Web3 technology company built on the backbone of our existing, you know, VFX studio. And with that, we've been able to really tap into a large pool of artists and people that have been able to really bring us top level content and quality. And through that, we're putting together basically a P2E cinematic universe where characters come to life as a television show, and they also come to life inside of our P2E Unreal Engine 5 video game. Now, the way that this works is we have a very, very cool set of artwork, which we've recently minted out our Genesis collection, sold out all of the NFTs. If you're interested in buying one of them, you can find them on Rarible. You can also find them on OpenSea and other places. But our sitters, which are what you see here, act as avatars as well as passports into our ecosystem and universe of NFTs and Web3. You pick up a sitter, you are then able to enter into this wide world of wonders and then participate in the next phase, which of course is our 3D avatars. And so I, myself, Alpha 4, am a phase 2 avatar NFT. This, myself, I am an NFT. So what will happen is that you will see effectively all of the NFTs from our Rarible account, from, you know, the mint that we've done recently, all these cool NFTs will become 3D. And from there, then you will be able to do exactly what we're doing here. You'll be able to embody all of your avatars through motion capture facial blend shapes, through IK rigs, through motion capture suits and technology. And of course, you know, we're going to be doing some things with our community where we're going to be showcasing some Xsens technology and hopefully getting some of them set up with different things. We've also got some great partnerships with other NFT projects that are looking to get into this. One specifically that we've been working with is Vajira. If anybody's familiar with them, they're a great NFT project that has done some really great community building and work over the last year. Quite well known, quite big. They just partnered up with Audi and some other great people. We're building some great mocap content for them that's going to be coming into fruition over the next few months and over the next year. And so that's going to be really exciting to watch. And there's a handful of other projects as well that are talking to us about creating these different things for them as well, all utilizing Xsens. Now, the cool thing is that once you've got this character that can, you know, walk around and do all these things, you can also bring him into our game and play that character inside the PTE. And inside that PTE, one of the cool things that we're going to be offering is we're going to be offering motion prints. So if you're not familiar with what a motion print is, it's how you walk, how you swagger. The best example that I can give is sort of like Conor McGregor, Vince McMahon, something along those lines where, you know, somebody's walking in and like it's just like a very exaggerated type of walk and cadence. And I think that, you know, the great Remco, as we have come to know him in regards to his great social media content he's been putting out recently, he, you know, has been a big proponent, I think, of motion prints. And we've been talking about that quite a lot. And he and I both agree that motion prints are going to be a thing of the future where it's going to be a representation of your character, of your status, in a sense. Motion prints themselves, in terms of these animations through motion capture, will become NFT content that people can buy and upgrade for your characters and games. You can see that kind of now with finishing moves and things like that. You know, those are all motion capture based things for the most part. And now basically we're able to bring more and more of those to life through the democratization of motion capture through things like Xsens, which make it so clean and smooth and the workflow just so easy. And I think, again, that's the big thing here is that, you know, there are other motion capture solutions, but nothing is as accurate as this. Nothing gives us this data that we're then able to take in very quickly and then put together in Unreal 5 for cinematics, which we'll show you a few of in a minute. And that's just, it's just a smooth workflow. It's smooth, it's fast, and it's efficient. And we skip steps that we used to have to do that were very laborious, such as hand animating. Oh, wait, my face went out. Hold on, sorry about that. Okay, we're back. So that is just the thing that really allows us to really take this to the next level. And with that, I'm gonna show you guys a couple things that we've built together at Sombra, one for Xsens and one for our great client NARS. And we're gonna show you really how we brought that motion capture technology into the client world as well as sort of our own cinematic world to start off with. Now, give me a minute because we do have to switch audio inputs and that will take 1 second. So bear with us for just a moment. All right, so what we're going to start off with here is we're going to show you guys a nice cinematic that we created for NARS. Basically, they've been really getting into the metaverse recently. They're doing a lot of activations over the next year. They're really going to be taking it, I think, to the next level. And so with that, we're really excited to be able to show you guys this one little piece that we did for them. So with that, let me bring it up. Ain't nobody gonna stop me. Don't you let the music stop now. You're more than just anybody. Don't give up, the future starts now. Worry about it in the morning. Take it to another level. You're more than just anybody. Don't give up, the future starts now.
One day everyone will notice. The world is closing, you should know it. So don't let love get out of focus. I know you can take the pressure. Turn it into something better. Don't give up the future's good time. Worry about it in the morning. Take it to another level. You're open to spending money. Don't give up the future's good time. Take it to
now again, that was, you know, created in a very short amount of time. We were able to do that, of course, because of Xsens and because of Manus, and I think that that's really, you know, a testament to, you know, what we were able to do in a really short amount of time. You know, we really only had 2 weeks effectively to create that from concept to create to finish and completion. And it obviously took quite a lot of time because there were really specific requests. It wasn't just like, you know, stream of consciousness from us. It was a very client specific oriented process. So yeah, I mean, it was really amazing to be able to do that with Xsens and with Manus and with these technologies, because without it, it really would never have been possible. So yeah. So again, you know, it's really an amazing thing where we're able to really bring to life characters in this capacity. You know, we've never been able to do something quite like this before, and I don't think that you're really going to see, you know, a lot of things like this coming from other NFT projects. You know, there are a few that luckily have, you know, been able to really put some great things together. I know that there was JPunks earlier, and there's a few others that, you know, have been able to utilize this type of technology, but I really do think that this is the future, and so do we at Sombra. And Xsens obviously is leading the way in terms of really, 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 really perfect data. And so, again, that just makes everything possible, because you can do something with a really small team and an Xsens that you could never have done before and would have taken ages to effectively put together. And so this is really something where we're not just excited about, you know, what we're creating, but we're also excited about what other people are creating and where they're going to take the journey of motion capture technology with NFTs. And so within the world of NFT and Web3, you know, the motion capture technology plays a big part because everything moves very quickly. You need to get content out. And we also really, really need to be able to make a game quickly. And that's the only way you can do it is motion capture. And Xsens is letting independent games, small teams do that in a really, really new and innovative way. And so this is the future of storytelling, you know, not just video games and video game content, which I think is historically what motion capture has really been, you know, founded in. Obviously that people have been using motion capture for films for a long time, but, you know, we really think that motion capture combined with real-time visual effects software such as Unity and Unreal Engine is the future of storytelling, because it allows people to make and create in record speed. You don't have to think and focus on things that you used to before that were laborious and time-consuming, took away from the creative process. Now you can just create, and that's the beauty of it, you know, and with a few simple clicks and setups, you can really get perfection with motion capture through Xsens. With that, you know, I'm going to just show you guys a couple quick things, you know, about our project. You know, if you're interested in purchasing a Xsens to participate in our ecosystem, you can definitely find, you know, that here through rareable.com and Xsens of Shadow, our collection here on the amazing platform. You can also find it on OpenSea, but we really like Rarible. You can check them out. You know, there's some that are between 0.15 ETH all the way up to 10 ETH if you're feeling bold. But either way, you can check these out on Rarible. And if you're interested, you can also join up our Discord, which we're always excited to have new members for. So please make sure that you do that and, you know, say hi to us. So yeah, I mean, the thing, I guess, you know, you can also see, which I think is fun to showcase here, is like, here I am in MVN, you know, and we can do a side by side. So you can see sort of what's happening. You know, you can also see me, and, you know, we're basically all moving in unison. Hopefully I don't hurt myself. And I think that's the other amazing thing is, like, you know, this ability here to touch hands like that, that's really unheard of in motion capture. Not a lot of other vendors really are even able to bring it close to that type of, you know, accuracy. And this is very roughly calibrated nonetheless, but it's extremely accurate, which is just a testament. I can't say enough about how fast this allows us to work. It's really amazing. And so with that, let's see if we can go and check out a couple things about the website, which we would love to talk about. So here you can see the team. Here's me, our head of community. Here's my good pal Monica, our head of community. Michal, she is a great software developer as well as a visual effects supervisor. She's been in New York doing some great work for quite a long time. I worked with her at a few shops when I was in New York. Demian, I'm sure you all know already, and you can check him out. We've got some great web and blockchain developers, Chris and David. We've got Gene Nazarov, our creative director, who spearheaded the NFL and Super Bowl NFTs. Jason and Aaron, our partners here, as well as Silver, our blockchain developer, our marketing agency, CryptoZen, and of course, Unit 256, our friend that we were talking about earlier. And how does this work, basically? Effectively, the way that this project operates is that you own your characters, you own the IP, you own everything about them, which is really where motion capture comes into play to an extent. You can embody your characters and do whatever you want with them. If you want to take your character and vlog with it, if you want to take your character and put it on a t-shirt, if you want to take your character and make a restaurant with it, you can do whatever you want. We obviously are hoping people and promoting people to, you know, take their characters into Twitch and into the metaverse. We want them to, you know, make videos, make content with them. We want them to be using motion capture to really be creating and becoming these characters. We also allow you basically to then control your character inside of this television show narrative that we create. Each month, we're creating a cinematic television show inside Unreal Engine 5 using Xsens and Manus, as well as Faceware motion capture technology, to bring these characters to life. And these characters that people own are then entered into this television show as the stars, the villains, the love interests. And each month, the community votes on the plot points, a multiple, very complicated plot point system that allows people to basically choose the direction of their character's fate and the story itself. So it's a choose your own adventure television show built with motion capture technology and Unreal Engine 5. You also, in a really fun way, get to watch it in VR via Oculus if you choose. We have the option where you can basically, in a limited parameter, go and then investigate the television show as a fly on the wall and walk through it, experiencing that TV show in real time as if you were there when it was filmed. Now, obviously, it's an animated television show, which is how this is possible, but you get the picture. This is inspired by a play in New York City called Sleep No More. If you're not familiar with it, please look it up. Sleep No More. It's a really great interactive play experience, which we're really striving to bring, I think, into this television show. Now, again, motion capture technology is really the only way that you can do this, which is really how all of this comes to life and how many of our community members will be becoming these characters. Now, here you can see some of the other 3D characters that we have in our ecosystem. These characters are all fully motion capture capable. They've got lens shapes, they've got fingers, they've got everything that you will need to utilize them in the metaverse for motion capture as well as in the game, and if you're interested in doing, you know, some other stuff with it. So it's really a great opportunity for people to really jump into motion capture. We're also offering services for people to get started in motion capture if they want basically to have us help them get set up. We will offer, you know, tutorials for how to set up all of their IPs and how to get the suit set up, how to get into the suits, you know, how to stream the suits into iClone and into Unreal, and then also how to very, very simply build some levels in Unreal that they can, you know, use to Twitch stream and vlog with. And we're really excited about this. Obviously, you know, this cinematic television show is paired with our PTE game. Each month, our PTE game releases missions that are correlated to the storyline and shares the same television show as the storyline for the game. So that's going to be really exciting, and we're all really, really excited about this. And we're really excited to take this journey with Xsens. And I guess with that, I'm opening it up to questions.
All right. Brendan, excellent presentation. Thank you very much. We've got lots of great questions here from the chat. First question we actually have, I'm going to kick this over to Thomas so we can address that one.
Yes. So the question we have is regarding regarding using the Windows system with the Reolution pipeline. So Brendan, I'll go ahead and answer the tech side of this part if you want to handle the Reolution side.
Sure, so, we don't use a window, just to be clear. We're only using the link systems, but I'm sure it's probably pretty similar. So what's the question?
Right, so I'll go ahead and handle the hardware side of it. The difference between using the link and the window for specifically live streaming is the fact that the window system has 17 wireless trackers, and they all operate on a 2.4 gigahertz protocol. It is in a window protocol, so it's not the standard Bluetooth, but you are going to run into, or you have a higher chance of running into wireless interference just due to all of those different connections, as opposed to the link suit, which is all of your trackers wired to a body pack, which is the one wireless connection. So that's something to keep in mind for live streaming. As far as the actual pipeline in Reolution and the workflow for that, I'll go ahead and kick that over to Brendan. So Brendan, if you just want to kind of give your thoughts on live streaming into Reolution, how that whole process works for you.
It goes really well. I think, you know, you can see here clearly how smooth it is. I'd say, you know, there's a lot of different things you have to take into consideration when doing like live streaming from any motion capture technology. And, you know, again, there's a lot of different ways you can do it. You know, you can stream directly into iClone and just do that, which is what we're doing right now, just because it's a little bit more efficient and it also is a little bit more high fidelity with some of the shaders in regards to these characters, which is a little bit more fun to sort of play with and look at. But Unreal 5 has some great developments that, you know, we're still pushing, but unfortunately they haven't released their Reolution Live Link app for Unreal 5, so that's not a capability yet. That's something that people can do. Soon we hope that that'll, you know, basically become an option that's, you know, accessible. Basically, though, I would say, you know, going from MVN, every time you go to a new program, so when you go from MVN and then you go into Reolution and then you go into Unreal, you're slowing down a little bit every time. So the best course of action is, like, if you want to go straight into Unreal, sometimes you might want to go just straight in through, you know, Live Link or a different mechanism. But, you know, I do find that Reolution's facial features for their blend shapes, as well as just, like, the overall experience is really, really beneficial in terms of sort of character movements and repurposing sort of the animations, being able to clean them up and things like that. It's been a really great workflow for us. But you definitely have to have a robust machine to be able to stream these things and to be able to do them in real time. So, I mean, we're running currently off of a, you know, RTX 6000, which is actually probably not an optimized GPU for this, to be candid. Really, I think recommended is 3090 if you're looking to do this for real. You definitely want to have something that's going to have capabilities. So, you know, I would recommend at least like 64 gigs of RAM, 3090 GPU. You could probably get away with a 2080, but it's going to have some limitations. You definitely don't want cloth sims on. Things like that will really mess you up because they're just going to take too much power away from the overall system. So yeah, I mean, it's always a trade when you're doing those things. But I've found that Reolution has been a really amazing platform and program, and I wish that more people would start using it.
Okay, we just had a quick question coming in regarding to your information there. The question is, can the 3080 handle it as well?
Yeah, I'd say the 3080 is fine. But like when you, like a 1080 is not going to cut it. And even like there are certain cards that aren't optimized for it. You know what I mean? Like an RTX 6000, even though it's a great GPU, it's not an optimized card for real time. So that's where you get into problems because it's not necessarily going to benefit you based on the statistics of the GPU. So you really got to look at that and just go and say, hey, like what's the best real time GPU? Because like there's really good GPUs for VFX and for rendering and for CG. But they may not be as good for real time. But again, 3090s, 3080s, 2080s, supers, things like that are really going to get you a good place. I mean, if you can get your hands on anything better than a 3090, I would go for it. But those are going to get pricey.
Awesome. Thank you very much for the answers. We've got another question in chat from Brandon. Are you using Character Creator? Curious about the character creation process. And if that's why the PFP, that profile picture, in the second image is the second image, and then it unlocks a 3D avatar in game since you can't sell the models from CC, although I'm not sure what that stands for.
So no, we don't use the models from Character Creator to do anything. We basically only create everything in Maya effectively, and then we assemble everything after the fact and then bring them over into iClone. So we don't actually use any of the things from Character Creator. We only use basically the, you know, models that we create and then use it to assemble things together. That answers the question.
Perfect. Next question I have, I actually have a couple questions here. One of them being, what are some of the TV shows you've been featured in so far?
The TV shows we've been featured in? I don't think we've been featured in any TV shows. I mean, like, our visual effects studio does work for, you know, different TV shows on HBO and all sorts of things like that. But I mean, as a project, we've only been in existence for a year. And these avatars and these Xsens multiverse has only been in existence for 6 months. So we're, you know, just getting started and we're just starting to build these things out, but we're creating our own TV show. I'm not sure if we're going to be featured on others, but who knows, maybe.
God, I think that was the nature of the question, was some of those HBO shows and things like that.
I mean, we've worked on things like Jet, we've worked on Monsterland. We've worked on, I'm trying to think of all the TV shows that we did that one year. Oh God. We worked on Shameless. We worked on, what were some of those other ones? We worked on The Purge, like that TV show. And we also worked on all the Purge films as well. We worked on some independent films with some directors that I'd have to go look up. I can't even remember. But yeah, you can go to our website and check the reels out too. You can see a lot of stuff you'll probably recognize. But we do mainly commercial work. So we're doing like high-end stuff for, you know, brands. You can go and look at mainly what we've done over the last year. I think it's been stuff for, you know, like Samsung and Best Buy. And we did a great PSA that was, you know, utilizing motion capture also actually for partnership to end addiction. That's a really beautiful piece. If you want to go check that out, it's, you know, 2 minutes long. The Lumineers did the score to it. So that's another example of motion capture technology that was really great, and that was for a great cause too. So make sure that you go check that out.
Perfect. We have a couple of questions here that I'm going to string together into kind of one question. A few notes about some issues that folks have had using Real Illusion with thumb data coming into Real Illusion. Kind of the nature of the question is, there's an issue there. Wondering how you got around that, or how you addressed that, or if you found the same issues with the thumbs coming into Real Illusion.
Yeah, so we do. I mean, you can see it here. My thumb is a little bit off kilter. It's too far over. There is no way that we are aware of, with Manus at least, to be able to fix that issue. You can fix it very easily after the fact by just simply, after you record the animation data, then setting one keyframe by rotating the finger into the position that you want, and then basically it should counteract all of those animations and it's usually fine. If you need to, sometimes you have to do extra cleanup on the hands, just as, you know, it is the nature of hands. There are new hand sort of solutions that are kind of evolving and utilizing AI technology, which are becoming more and more accurate. And so some of those things you can look into as well if it's giving you problems, but generally it's not something that we really care too much about. It doesn't become problematic for us.
Perfect, good.
I can jump in on that as well.
Yeah, go right ahead, Thomas.
So the customer that's bringing this up, we have, a previous customer has brought up this issue as well with the iClone thumb. And it's something that we actually reached out to Real Illusion about. I believe the resolution of that was that Real Illusion would update their Xsens profile in their plugin. So Brendan, I'm not sure if you're using the most recent version of the plugin or if there, you know, are there any updates available or anything like that.
We can always check. Not sure.
Yeah, but I guess my recommendation for that would just be, double check to make sure that your software is fully updated. See if that updated profile will help you at all for that thumb issue. And if not, you can always reach out to Xsens support and we can take a look at it deeper.
Cool. Sounds good.
Cool. We've got another question from the chat here from Alton. How are players interacting with the series who don't have mocap, referring to the Xsens series?
Hold on, let me fix my face really quick. Okay. Sorry, I had to take the headgear off. Occasionally, you do need to take a break, otherwise your brain explodes. Yeah, so how are characters able to interact? And hey, I do apologize, it's probably going to be a mess. But anyway, characters can interact with the show in a number of ways. You know, we don't really require motion capture by any means for people to interact. It's just something that we think is really interesting, and we want to be able to offer that as a solution for people in the future. It is obviously to some people a bit of a high price point, so it's not going to be for everybody, but we do think that as our brand grows and the project becomes more well-known, people are going to be able to take these characters that have a really well-recognized brand and be able to use them in their own world and kind of, you know, play off of that as well. But if you wanted to participate in the ecosystem, you know, you can own an NFT, and you could, if you own two or more of our Genesis NFTs, you basically get one of these 3D NFTs for free. Those are all created in Maya, you know, customized by our team by hand, and, you know, then assembled either in Maya or Character Creator based on what the need is. And then, you know, basically exported out as an FBX. Now, for us, we use Character Creator for the streaming series, basically, and to make the television show, but we're not using it to actually assemble the characters. So, you know, just depends on the need of the person, but, you know, we also sort of help them set up with, like we said, iClone if they want to, but if they don't want to use Mocap, you know, they can play our PTE game, which will be coming out in a few months, and they can use their avatar, their 3D avatar in that PTE game. They can also use their avatar in an upcoming social app where we utilize blend shapes to allow you to basically create animations where you talk and sing and do whatever you want as your avatar. And then you can pair that with uploaded animations that we create in Xsens. So we basically each week we like look at what the latest YouTube trends are, and, you know, not YouTube, excuse me, TikTok. I'm not the one doing the trends, don't worry. But we check what they are, and, you know, we kind of like go with, you know, what's popular, and then we, you know, create animation data that we think is fun each week, and we upload those into our app, and those characters then you can basically bring your NFT character if you own it through your Web3 wallet and make videos and social media content with your character on your phone. That's still in progress. You know, we had a great development team out of Ukraine, unfortunately, that we have been trying to help sort of get back together and on their feet, and, you know, it's been a little bit slower than we wanted, but that should be coming out in a couple months as well, and once that comes out, you'll be able to take these 3D characters and basically, you know, use them there as well.
And just to confirm, we had a couple questions in the chat. PTE guys stands for play to earn, just yes. So that you're aware. One other question we had, what do you recommend if you don't have faceware hardware and software for facial motion capture animation?
Well, I mean, the facial stuff, I think it's free. Like, you know, I think, you know, you can use Unreal Engine is free. So you can download Unreal and install that on your computer. And then Live Link for Unreal is also free, which you can download as an app on your phone. And from there, you can stream directly into Unreal. And I don't think you have to spend any money as long as you have an iPhone.
Free is always good. We like free here. I think that is just about all. Let me just go back through one more question, actually. How many blend shapes in the facial area?
So we're utilizing 52 blend shapes as per sort of the normal AR kit. Now, I think iClone itself utilizes like 128 actual different muscle groups, but it's still 52 blend shapes as per AR kit. But we do, I think that with faceware, when we get that partnership finished and spun up, that will be, I think, 128, but I'm not 100% sure. I'd have to double check.
Gotcha. Thomas, if there's no more questions from your end, I think we've just about got them all here.
We did just get one, and this is a really good question that I'd love to ask you, Brendan. The question is, do you have any recommendations for headgear for holding the iPhone? You're using it for like live link face.
Yeah, for sure. You know, HMC is a good one, but it's expensive. It's about $1,250. And then I recommend the counterweight as well, which is another $200. But if you're looking for something affordable, you know, you can check out, you know, Perception has a helmet that's really good. That's cheap. It's like $800. It's not going to get you what you want in terms of like high fidelity action sequences because it's just a little too clunky, but it's good for just like everyday use and things like that. HMC, obviously the one that we're wearing now, is really, really good. You know, you also can make your own fairly inexpensively. And, you know, Demian and I run a really big Facebook group on Facebook. It's got about 20,000 members, all catered to Unreal Engine. And we also run another really big one called Motion Capture. I have to go and double check the exact name, but the motion capture group on Facebook, the big one, as well as our Unreal Engine, those two groups together have a lot of great members in them that have done a lot of DIY on helmets that you can tap into. So if you're interested, you know, please get my email and I'm happy to direct you to some of those people and we can definitely get you set up. And there's a lot of great YouTube videos as well that you can just go online and look up mocap helmet, and people have uploaded great solutions for that.
Okay. And Brendan, what would be the best way for people to contact you?
You can just shoot me an email at brendan@sombra.app, and my name is Brendan, B-R-E-N-D-A-N, at Sombra, S-O-M-B-R-A, .app, A-P-P.
Brendan, thank you very much for coming on and giving an excellent presentation. We really do appreciate your time.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you so much for having us. We really appreciate it, and we really hope that you guys get a chance to check out Xsens and Sombra.